Let us now study the decay of current in a LR circuit. Here you can see there is an active inductor which carries an initial current I0, or I0 was the current through the inductor when it was disconnected from a current growing circuit, and I0 was the last current which was flowing in the inductor when it was cut. If it is connected with the resistance along with the switch, and say the switch is closed at t equal to 0, then the same current will start flowing through it, and as the current flows, some heat will be produced in the resistor according to Joule-Heating effect, and the energy comes from the stored magnetic energy in the inductor. So here we can say that the value of current must gradually go down, so that the magnetic energy stored will be gradually transformed into the thermal energy in the resistance. Now in this situation, as inductor is always connected in parallel with the resistance, here we can write Ldi by dt is equals to IR. The potential difference of the two must be same, and here as current is decreasing with time, we must use this as minus Ldi by dt. Now in this situation, di by I can be written as R by L dt with a negative sign, and if we integrate this expression, here we can see at t equals to 0 when the switch was closed, the first current flowing through the inductor was I0, and at any general time t, say the current is I. We integrate, this will be ln of I by I0, which is equals to minus RT by L. And on simplifying, we are getting the current in the circuit as I0 e to the power minus RT by L. This is the expression for current through the inductor when its current decays through a resistance R connected with it. Now if we plot a time variation of this current, here you can see initially at t equals to 0, the current in it was I0, and gradually it decays with time exponentially, and it will drop down to 0 at a very long time duration, or we can say in a steady state. And here again we can see at time constant, which is equals to L by R, the value of current will drop to I0 by E, which is 0.37 of I0. This is what we can use. Now in this situation we can also see, if we calculate the thermal energy produced in inductor, this thermal energy produced can be written as total heat as integration of I square R dt, which can be integrated from 0 to infinity if we calculate the total thermal energy. So here you can see, if we substitute the value of I over here and we integrate, we can directly state that the value of this integral will finally come out as half Li square, because it was the energy stored in the inductor which was supplying this thermal energy. I am leaving this integration as an exercise for you to solve and verify whether you are getting the same result or not.